Good morning, dear students. We are talking about our lesson, our environment, which is from biology. EVS topic it is actually. So yesterday's class we have seen its introductory part it was of our environment. So in that we have seen how our earth is designed. This is designed with the various kinds of spheres, that is lithosphere, then atmosphere and hydrosphere. And because of all this, how biosphere is formed, or for the biosphere, how these all layers are convenient to survive, and what is our intervention effect on the environment, that also we have seen. So concept of the environment I tried to clear yesterday. Then components of the environment we have seen. Then resources, what is meant by resources, the concept of resources we have seen. And later on we have seen two types of the waste also we have seen. So our today's topic is ecosystem. Okay, so ecosystem is actually what? I will give you one example. I'll draw here a small figure, and through that I shall try to explain you the concept of the ecosystem. In the ecosystem, actually yesterday we have talked about ecosystem is actually composed of biotic components and abiotic components. Biotic components means living things, and abiotic components means non-living things. Then how these biotic components and abiotic components require each other, or how they are depend on each other. If there will be one component, maybe it is not performing its role, then how it may affect on the other component, that we will see with the help of the diagram. So here the interaction or the harmonious relationship between biotic factors and abiotic factors we are going to see. So here I will give example of a pond, simple pond example, which I am talking about natural aquatic ecosystem. Okay, so here I will give example of a natural aquatic ecosystem.
Good yield from it.
when these big fishes would die, whenever they would die, their dead bodies, will it remain as it is into this natural aquatic ecosystem? No, this will not remain as it is. These big fishes will be used as a food by the decomposers. Okay, decomposers, what will come into the decomposers? Microbes. Microbes. Which microbes will come? Microbes like fungi, bacteria, some insects would come into the decomposers. Because what would these decomposers would do? These are the large fishes, large dead bodies are eaten. Are eaten means are synthesized. Because decomposers, these big fishes' body are made up of the complex organic material. Okay? Complex organic material we convert into simpler inorganic one. That is breaking down decomposers. Decomposition means what? Breaking down, separating out. Understood, student? Decomposition means what? Decomposition process is what? Separating out. Okay, in the chemistry first topic you will learn decomposition reaction. So it will be more clearer for you. Combination means what? Combine. Two nutrients combine. So here decomposition means what? Separating out. Understood? So here what would happen? Decomposers, we separate complex organic. Whatever they according to them it is called. So complex organic material, complex organic compound will get separate into simpler inorganic one. Understood? And that this process will be done with the help of some enzymes. Actually, decomposers cannot convert complex into simpler form. Here, decomposers contain some specific kind of enzymes in them, and because of the enzymes, they are digesting the food out of the body because these are too small. They don't have a proper digestive system to digest the food inside the body. So what they would do, they would digest this food according to them it is food. They would digest the food outside of the body with the help of the enzymes. So complex organic food will get converted into simpler inorganic one with the help of the enzymes. Understood? And now what would happen? These decomposers will utilize this food, food as a food, this will provide them nutrients also. For decomposers, it will provide nutrients. At the same time, some part of it, the part which they do not require, will be accumulated into the soil in the form of humus. Do you know, student? Humus. The top layer soil contains humus, a large amount of humus is present, which is top layer, which makes the soil more fertile. So that all, the part which insect or microbes do not require, will be in the soil. And what would happen here? These plants will utilize these nutrients again to produce the food. So in this manner, this is one kind of cycle you can see. Plants are again utilize these nutrients. This will be eaten by the small fishes will be eaten by the big fishes will be decomposed by microbes, and microbes will give to the into the soil some specific kind of nutrients. So this is one kind of biogeochemical cycle. So various biogeochemical cycles are present in our environment. We have seen carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle in class 9. In natural resources, you have seen carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle, water cycle. So various cycles are present, and in that cycle, those cycles are called as a biogeochemical cycle. Why these cycles are called as a biogeochemical cycles? Because in those cycles, biotic factors and abiotic factors are dependent on each other. They are, their interaction is present, and they are living in harmony. Their mutual relationship is preserved, is maintained. Understood? So they are dependent on each other, and they are taking help of each other and living in a harmony, and this causes ecological balance. Balance of ecosystem is maintained because of such biogeochemical cycle. So this cycle is very, very important. See, students, if these plants are removed from, what would happen? These small fishes could not get the food. Small fishes could not get the food, means big fishes could not get the food. Nothing will survive if any of it you try to or the highest human beings participation is required into that pond or mountain. Yes, our participation does not require. Whenever human is interfering in any of the ecosystem, that ecosystem is called as an artificial ecosystem. Natural ecosystem do not require intervention of human beings. And whenever the human beings is interfering or taking part in a particular ecosystem, that ecosystem is called as an artificial ecosystem. So, do you get the concept of natural ecosystem and the artificial ecosystem? Natural ecosystem means human intervention does not require, and artificial ecosystem is made by the human. Okay. Now, if human is not interfering in it, then the ecological balance is maintained. Do you understand, students? So, natural ecosystems are also called as a self-sustainable ecosystem. Self-sustainable ecosystems. Because our participation does not require them. They are not dependent on human beings. If anything, any huge animal, any elephant or any huge animal would die into the forest, do we go there for the antim sanskar? Do we go there? No, we do not go there for it. Because this ecosystem is managing it. But in the artificial ecosystem, say example of our at home, we have a fish tank. In that fish tank, if any fish would die, we are trying to remove it. Externally, we are providing oxygen. Externally, we are providing food for the fishes. So that ecosystem is actually not self-sustainable ecosystem. Means these organisms, these biotic and abiotic factors cannot manage themselves properly. And self-sustainable ecosystem means what? In that system, those plants and animals can manage themselves. Means abiotic factors and biotic factors can manage themselves in the natural ecosystem. So, the difference, the second difference between artificial and the natural ecosystem is that natural ecosystem is a self-sustainable ecosystem, while artificial ecosystem is not a self-sustainable ecosystem. Okay, so here three differences would come. First is what? Human participation does not require into the natural ecosystem, and in an artificial ecosystem, human participation is required. Second point is natural ecosystem is a self-sustainable ecosystem, while